Hello friends, how are you all? Welcome to Sri Spoken English. This is Srinivas and this video lesson 111. Friends, manam prati roju kuda English grammar lo most important topics paina test rastu unna mana Sri Spoken English channel lo ee roju manam discuss cheyabetvanti video lesson check your English grammar direct and indirect speech. सो मन के अन्नी कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स इंग्लिश ग्रामर पैन एलांटी टेस्ट अड़ता सो मन इंग्लिश ग्रामर ने इंप्रूवाइज़ चेसुकोवाली अने सीरीज भागंगा मनम टेस्ट ने 15 मार्क्स की मनम स्कोर चेसुकुंटाम फ्रेंड्स राइट यस लेट अस बी गेट स्टार्टेड Directions. ఈ 15 questions answer చేసిన తర్వాత మీకు ఎంత స్కోర్ వస్తుందో కామెంట్ సెక్షన్ లో మీ నేమ్ తో పాటు మీ మార్క్స్ ని కూడా ఎంటర్ చేయండి ఇంకా ఏమైనా డౌట్స్ ఉన్నా కూడా మనం క్లారిఫై చేసుకుందాం ఫ్రెండ్స్ yes let us get started directions choose the correct direct indirect speech of the following statements so ఇచ్చినటువంటి ఇండైరెక్ట్ స్టేట్మెంట్ నుంచి డైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్లో నుంచి ఇండైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్లోకి మార్చాలి సో ఇక్కడ 4 ఆప్షన్స్ ఇవ్వబడతాయి ప్రతి క్వశ్చన్కి సో మీ రైట్ ఆన్సర్ ఏంటో మీరు మనసులో గుర్తు చేసుకోండి సో ప్రతి క్వశ్చన్ తర్వాత 4 ఆప్షన్ చదివిన తర్వాత ఆన్సర్ ఇవ్వడం జరుగుతుంది సో మీరు పెట్టినటువంటి క్వశ్చన్ రైటా కాదా అనేది చెక్ చేసుకోవచ్చు ఫ్రెండ్స్ ఎస్ ఫస్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ డూ యూ వాంట్ టు కమ్ విత్ మీ షీ సెడ్ టు హిమ్ డూ యూ వాంట్ టు కమ్ విత్ మీ షీ సెడ్ టు హిమ్ Friends, let us observe the statement. Okay, whether it is assertive sentences or interrogative sentences or exclamatory sentences. So, దాని పైన డిపెండ్ చేసుకొని మనం ఆప్షన్ చూస్ చేసుకోవాల్సి ఉంటుంది ఫ్రెండ్స్ చాలా చాలా కీలకంగా మారేటువంటి ఈ డైరెక్ట్ ఇండైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్లో ప్రతి ఎగ్జామ్స్ కూడా చాలా చాలా ఇంపార్టెంట్ సో డూ యూ వాంట్ టు కమ్ విత్ మీ సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎ ఇంటరాగేటివ్ క్వశ్చన్ రైట్ సో డూ యూ వాంట్ టు కమ్ ఎస్ ఆర్ నో టైప్ క్వశ్చన్ రైట్ ఆక్సిలరీ వర్బ్ క్వశ్చన్స్ సో హియర్ ఇలాంటి హెల్పింగ్ వర్బ్ క్వశ్చన్స్ లేదా ఎస్ఆర్ నో టైప్ క్వశ్చన్స్కి మనం ఇఫ్ కానీ వెదర్ కానీ ఆన్సర్లో యాడ్ చేస్తాం సో దాన్ని మనం గుర్తు చేసుకొని ఆన్సర్ ఇద్దరు చూద్దాం ఆన్సర్ ఏ షీ టోల్డ్ హిమ్ దాట్ షీ వాంటెడ్ టు కమ్ విత్ హిమ్ బి షీ ఆస్క్డ్ హిమ్ వెదర్ హీ వాంటెడ్ టు గో విత్ హర్ షీ ఆస్క్డ్ హిమ్ వెదర్ షీ వాంటెడ్ టు కమ్ విత్ హిమ్ డి షీ ఆస్క్డ్ హిమ్ వెదర్ హీ వాంట్స్ కమ్ విత్ హర్ సో విచ్ ఈస్ ద రైట్ ఆన్సర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ లెట్ అస్ గెస్ ఎస్ హియర్ కమ్ బికమ్స్ డెఫినెట్లీ గో ఓకే డోంట్ కన్ఫ్యూజ్ అండ్ అగైన్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు యాడ్ ఇఫ్ ఆర్ వెదర్ ఓకే రైట్ So the first is not at all suitable, just remove it and B, C, D, which is the right answer. Already in the C and D, they just give come, come, right? Come here, in the direct speech, come, it becomes into indirect speech as go. Come anedi indirect speech loki marchinappudu go ga marutundi. So helping verb questions yes or no type questions kabatti whether ledha if ivvabadutundi. So right answer yes. First question right answer B. She asked him whether he wanted to go with her. So this is the right answer. Okay friends, next we can move on to the second one. I have seen this film twice. He said I have seen this film twice. Which kind of sentence is it? It is absolutely assertive sentence. Am I right? Yes. So the right answer becomes A. He said that he had seen that film twice. B. He told that he has been seeing that film twice. C. He said that he has been seeing that film twice. D. He said that he had seen this film twice. So which is the right answer? I have seen this film here the yes this becomes that film okay friends have seen so here have seen becomes had seen okay the right answer 2 A. He said that he had seen that film twice. That's absolutely right answer. Next question. Third one. Have you done your homework? Said the teacher to the student. What is the correct answer? The teacher told the student that he had done his homework. B. The teacher asked the student if he has done his homework. C. The teacher asked the student whether he had done his homework. D. The teacher said to the student whether he had done his homework. So already I told you this sentence starts with the yes or no type questions, right? Auxiliary verb have. So we have to add whether or if, and have you done your homework, said the teacher to the student. So the right answer C. The teacher asked the student whether he had done. Have you done? So you becomes he or she, okay? He had done. Have becomes had. He had done. So whether he had done his homework. Okay, so third one, C is the right answer. Next, fourth one. Nirja said, I'll be here within a short time. Which is the right answer? Yes, Nirja told that she would be there within a short time. B. Nirja said that she will be there within a short time. Nirja said that she would have to be there within a short time. Nirja said that she would be there within a short time. So which is the right answer, friends? Yes, Nirja said. It is absolutely assertive sentence. Okay, yes. So Nirja said that. Okay, yes, till here all options are same. Nirja said that. And I, who is I here? Yes, Nirja. So it becomes, we have to change the first person I into the third person. Whether it is female or male, it is female, so it becomes she. She will becomes automatically would. She would be. Here becomes automatically there. She would be there. Now you can see A, B, C, D, which is the right answer. Yes, said he would be there within a short time. So fourth question, D is the absolutely right. Next one, my grandfather said the earth moves around the sun. So friends, here this is the universal truth. So one thing you have to remember, so no changes will be there in the indirect speech for the universal truths. So automatically the answer becomes yes. Fifth one, my grandfather said that the earth moves around the sun. My grandfather said that the earth moved around the sun. My grandfather asked if the earth moves around the sun. Whether it is helping verb? No. So C is not at all suitable. Right. Next, D. My grandfather told that the earth moves around the sun. So right answer. A and D seems the same, but the little difference. My grandfather said that the earth moves around the sun. Here said that, and here told that. One thing you have to remember, if it becomes told, no need to add that conjunction. Okay, so the suitable correct answer here, A. My grandfather said that the earth moves around the sun. A, yes. Fifth question, A is the right answer. Next, move on to the sixth question, friends. I wish I did not have to take the examinations, said Mohan. What is the right answer? It is assertive sentence. Mohan said that he wished he did not have to take an examination. B. Mohan wished that he hadn't had to take examinations. Mohan wished that he did not have to take examinations. B. Last one. Mohan said that he wished he had not have to take examinations. So which is the right answer, friends? Yes. Right answer, A. Mohan said that he wished he did not have to take examinations. Okay,
yes.
Next, seventh one, how much chocolate do you eat every day? The dentist asked a little boy. So, how much chocolate do you eat every day? The dentist asked the little boy. So, which is the right answer, friends? Yes. It is absolutely interrogative sentence because the sentence begins with a WH question. How much? Yes. Let us, which is the right answer? Let us see. The dentist asked the little boy whether how much chocolate he ate every day. The dentist asked the little boy how much chocolate he eats every day. See, the dentist asked the little boy how much chocolate he ate every day. The dentist asked the little boy if how much chocolate he ate every day. So friends, just we have to follow, if it is a difficult one, we have to follow a termination method. Termination method means here not preferable answers we have to remove first. Okay, so it is WH question, definitely it not begins with yeah. We don't want to add if or whether. So D is not at all suitable. And now, what is the right answer? Let us search. The dentist asked, because it is, the question is interrogative, because we have to, reporting verb changed as asked. Okay, A, B, C are same, D also same, but we just removed here, right? Yeah. Next, the dentist asked the little boy how much chocolate he ate every day. Right, C is the right answer, because how much chocolate he ate every day. So how much, automatically it becomes how much chocolate that he ate. Okay, eat becomes ate. Simple present, it becomes simple past in the indirect speech. So friends, next we can move on to the eighth one. We shall be playing cricket tomorrow evening, the children said. This is the statement, right? Assertive one. Assertive statement. So which is the right answer? A, B, C, D. A, the children said that they would be playing cricket tomorrow evening. B, the children told that they should be playing cricket the next morning, the next day morning, evening. C, the children told we shall be playing cricket the next day evening. D, the children said that they would be playing cricket the next day evening. So obviously tomorrow, here indication is tomorrow becomes the next day. Okay, and now we can follow the termination method if you are not understand the four answers. Okay, yeah. So tomorrow, the next day, it becomes the next day, right? So A is the not at all suitable, just remove it. And next one, D is the right answer, because the children said that they would be playing. Here shall be or will be becomes would be, right? Would be playing cricket the next day evening. This is right answer. Next, ninth one, will you accompany me? Will you accompany me? He said to me. So what is the right answer? Yes, this is yes or no type question, right? Interrogative sentence, this is yes or no type question. So we have to add if or whether. A, B, C, D, which is the right answer? He asked if I would accompany him. He asked me whether I will accompany him. He asked if he accompany me. He asked me if he would accompany me. So which is the right answer? Yes, right answer. He asked if I would accompany him. Next, 10th one, he said to me, good morning, good morning. So what is the right answer? He wished that was good morning. He wished if it was good morning. He wished me that morning was good. He wished me good morning. Simply we can say that the answer is yes, D. He wished me good morning. Next, 11th one, what are you doing? Sita said. Sita asked, "What are you doing?" Because this is interrogative sentence, yes, WH question. It begins with WH question, right? What? Yes. And B, Sita asked what I was doing. Sita asked me what she was doing. D, Sita asked me what I am doing. So, right answer. B, Sita asked what I was doing. What I was doing. Here, you means she asked me, right? So, it becomes I. Okay, right answer, 11th one. Sita asked what I was doing. B is the right answer. 12th one. She said to me, "Is your name not Ahmed?" She said to me, "Is your name not Ahmed?" So, which is the right answer? A. She told me that my name was not Ahmed. B. She asked me whether her name was Ahmed. C. She inquired me whether my name was not Ahmed. D. She asked me if your name was not Ahmed. So, which is the right answer, friends? And here, termination method we can follow. Yes. Her name was. This is not at all suitable. Just remove it. And which is the right answer again? Yes. Said to me, "Is your name?" She is just making inquiry, right? Yes, right answer. She inquired me whether my name was not Ahmed. This is the C is the right answer. 13th one. She said to me, "Congratulations." She congratulated me. She told me to congratulate. She told me to congratulations. She asked me if I was congratulated. So it is not at all helping verb question. So we can remove D and A, B, C, which is the right answer. Absolutely, A is the right answer. She congratulated me. Simple. Next, 14th one. Trust in God and do the right, said the preacher. Trust in God and do the right, said the preacher. A. The preacher said that trust in God and do the right. B. The preacher asked trust in God and do the right. C. The preacher asked to trust in God and did the right. So D one, last one. The preacher preached to trust in God and do the right. So which is the right answer, friends? Yes, 14th one. D is the absolutely right. Last one, 15th one. Don't waste your time but work hard, said the teacher to the students. Which is the right answer? Can you guess? A. The teacher advised the students not to waste their time but work hard. The teacher asked to waste your time but work hard. Is it correct? No. No teacher suggested to students to waste their time, because B is not at all suitable. Remove it. And C, the teacher asked to not to waste our time but work hard. And D, the teacher asked don't waste our time but work hard. So which is the right answer? Absolutely, 15th one. A is the right answer. The teacher advised the students, because it is advice, imperative sentence. So automatically it is suggestion. Suggested or advised. This is the right answer. So don't forget, friends, if it is imperative sentence, whether it is advice or request, if it is request, we have to add requested. If it is exclamation sentence, exclaimed. So we have to add like reporting verbs. Okay, so 15th one, A is the correct answer. So friends, how much score did you get? And please mention it along with your name and your marks in the comment section. So thank you very much. Keep learning English, and I will catch you later with another interesting video. Thank you. See you later.